The year 1983 brought many new changes to the Ole Miss football program. A new coach in Billy Brewer, and a new attitude emphasizing hard work. It all starts with practice.
Everyone's watching.
After an 0-3 start, the Rebels picked up their first win in Jackson with an upset of then 19th-ranked Arkansas. The final, 13-10. Lost their next two games to Southern Miss and a powerful Georgia team. But at TCU, the season turned around and took a strange twist of fate. Returned home to face Vanderbilt for homecoming. With the offense struggling, Kelly Powell was inserted. The kid was hot.
Yeah.
LSU was next. The Rebels hadn't defeated the Tigers in many seasons, but this time it was Rebel time. Still, after an impressive win over LSU, few gave the Rebels any chance against highly ranked Tennessee. But before 95,000 screaming volunteer fans and a national TV audience, the Rebels played like maniacs.
To the second there, first thing I said, Mr. Lord, let me do one or two things. Strip him of the football or I make the tackle and don't let him score. She's a maniac, maniac.
Only arch-rival Mississippi State remained, and they stood between an Independence Bowl invitation and a winning season for the Rebels. The Egg Bowl was to have a magical ending.
Say yeah, we'll go.
Oh. Let's go, boy!
So proud of y'all, man. We came back.
Sorry,
man. I love all y'all.
Yeah, man.
This is Mr. Yarbrough, the Independence Bowl.
Yeah.
How you doing?
And I'm going to make this pretty brief. I was going to ask you if you wanted to go, but I think Billy's already answered that. So, Billy, Warner, Langston, on behalf of the Independence Bowl, sending you an invitation. Play the Air Force Academy.
For the first time in 12 seasons, the Rebels went bowling with an invitation to the Independence Bowl in Shreveport. The opponent was a fine, disciplined, high-powered Air Force Academy team. Bowl officials called it the best matchup in the bowl's history.
This is the end. You made your choice and now my chance is over. Thank you.
fumble?
Well, the fullback dived, and I got fullback responsibility on that defense. We were in an Eagle G, and I got my arm on it, and it popped loose, and I just fell right on top of it.
How could you hold on to a ball in these conditions?
It's tough, but you want it bad enough, it's yours.
Seemed to walk off the field with their heads up high, didn't they?
They have a lot of pride, and I'm proud of them. And they know, you know, I think they certainly feel that they gave their best, and that's all we've ever asked them, that they give their best, and when they walk off there, they know it's all out there on the field.
What about these seniors? What about these seniors?
I haven't ever, you know, I've been around a lot of good kids, a lot of in several programs, but I don't think I've been around a senior group that did more for a football program than these seniors did at Ole Miss. Not only are they winners and have they exemplified everything in the tradition of Ole Miss, but I tell you what, anytime they want to come see me, they got anything I have on me, I tell you that.
Dream of mine since I was in high school in Columbus, Mississippi, to be a player here, and that became a reality. And then 24 some odd years later, this again became a reality.
Mississippi.
Excited to be here, and every day I wake up, you know, and it's hard to believe. Billy Brewer, you're really an Ole Miss.
I'll be coming home again. Mississippi until you be on my Mississippi, until you be.
In considering All-American candidates in 1984, you have to take a look at Ole Miss defensive end Freddie Joe Nunn. His greatest assets, size and speed, while playing on a very intense level every game. Ladies and gentlemen, the Freddie Joe Show. Freddie Joe Nunn, All Southeastern Conference, All American, 1984. From the first day of practice, new head football coach Billy Brewer brought a breath of fresh air to an Ole Miss football program that had not been a winner in 5 years. This new crew of football coaches were tough disciplinarians and fighters. They instilled that spirit in the team, and Ole Miss fought for everything they achieved in 1983. In the first half of the season, there were only a few shining moments for the young Rebels. At Memphis State, they lost by 20 points to the Tigers, and Coach Brewer realized how far his new team had to come before believing in themselves. In game two against Tulane, senior Buford McGee sprinted up and down the Superdome for 167 yards, but the Rebels lost 27-23. Still, Buford's effort was tremendous, and he was named Offensive Player of the Game. The next week in Tuscaloosa, there was little to cheer about. The offense was completely shut down by Alabama. The Tide waved on Walter Lewis and company to a 40-0 shutout. At 0-3, some fans were already writing off the 83 season, but the men in blue pulled a stunning performance against 19th-ranked Arkansas in Game 4. Bulky junior nose guard Terry Williamson led the defensive charge with 10 tackles, and 9 catches by Jamie Holder helped the Rebs eke out a 13-10 victory.
I've seen twice in the 4 weeks that we've been with this football team a tremendous amount of heart. Whether or not we can maintain it remains to be seen the rest of the summer. But that is one hell of a start tonight, I'll tell you that, against the 19th team in the nation.
Ole Miss was improving, but they took a step backward the next week. In Game 5 against Southern Miss, the Rebs wasted 4 golden opportunities to score and lost it 27-7. A week later, the powerful Georgia Bulldogs were in Oxford, and they dismantled the Rebels 36-11. Despite the score, Coach Brewer believes the turning point of the season came in the fourth period. That's when senior Kelly Powell entered the game as quarterback and led a late touchdown drive.
Get your tail kicked. As far as I'm concerned, I'll take a bunch of kids in a fight like that when they're down and they're battling with the backs of the wall.
And they continued to battle. What would transpire over the next 5 weeks was everything diehard Rebel fans dreamed of and more. At 1-5, Ole Miss traveled to Texas Christian University and walloped the Horned Frogs 20-7. Nathan Wansley showed his stuff, rushing for 99 yards and a touchdown.
Heart, care, pride, out of-
I love it! Yeah!
Coach Brewer is known as an excellent motivator, and on homecoming day against Vanderbilt, an emotion-filled Rebel team knew it could win. Kelly Powell took over at quarterback this game, but watch number 29. Andre Rogers scores on a 37-yard reverse to make it 21-14 Rebels in the third period. That's when Townsend and company took over. Number 80, Big Dre, was the heart of the defensive line all year. The Vandy game ended dramatically. With just seconds left, Eric Truitt ruined Vandy's plans of a comeback with a game-saving interception in the end zone to seal a 7-point victory.
There ain't no way that we can't win the rest of our game.
That was the type of confidence the Rebels would show in Game 9 against LSU. Powell started his first game of the season and promptly hit 12 of 18 passes for two touchdowns, including this one to Timmy Moffitt. And this time it was junior Arthur Humphrey who ground up the lowly Bayou Bengals, the final 27-24 Ole Miss. It was sweet revenge for the team that Billy Brewer built.
It gives this program a big uplift, and for the future years, and I'm just glad to be a part of it, and I hope we can continue to win.
And some folks gave up on me and said, hey, you can have my tickets. Hey, they want them back now.
In Game 10, over 95,000 fans and a national television audience saw the heavily favored Vols take on the surging Rebs of Ole Miss. It would be a stunning night of success for Billy's boys. Neil Tevan booted two field goals, and Kelly Powell connected with Jamie Holder for a touchdown. That gave the Rebs enough for a 13-10 victory. Once more, it was the defensive crew that made the crucial plays.
Yeah, it is sweet, but it is also a bunch of kids that I'm just fascinated with.
This university has been down so long, we need some good things to happen to us. And under Coach Brewer, they're happening, What else can you act for?
The Egg Bowl was next, Mississippi State versus Ole Miss. A victory would mean a real bowl bid, the first in 12 years. State was ready, though. They jumped to a 17-0 lead. But being behind was nothing new to the comeback kids from Ole Miss. Junior Timmy Moffitt took off with a punt and never looked back. It was 17-7. In the fourth quarter, the Rebs were behind 23-7 when Kelly Powell strolled in for a touchdown after picking up a fumble at the one. Then Powell connected with Moffitt for another TD. Tevan came on and booted a 35-yarder to pull the Rebs to a 24-23 lead. State drove back to the Rebel 10 with just 24 seconds left, and it was field goal time. But Mother Nature did not cooperate. The kick was true, but a swirling 40-mile-an-hour wind slapped it down. In the papers the next day, it would be called the Immaculate Deflection. Ole Miss had come a long way, five straight wins. And in the locker room later, they received their payoff.
On behalf of the Independence Bowl, sending you an invitation to play the Air Force Academy. Yeah!
The Ole Miss faithful drove to Shreveport in force with plenty of hotty toddies that kept everyone fired up. In the mud and grime of Independence Bowl Stadium, four field goals would take care of all the scoring, and Ole Miss came out on the short end 9-3. But it was an inspired performance. The Reb defense proudly stopped Air Force again and again. The seniors shone: McGee, Townsend, Powell, Allen, Lewis, and Clark, Hall, Hubbard, Stewart, and Lovelady. They have been the start of something special at Ole Miss.
You look around and you see the tears in these guys' eyes. They hate to lose. They're not losers. In my opinion, they won this football game tonight because how they got here.